Right, so now I'm ready for an adventure. I have my shield, and an assortment of weapons. Why so many shields, you ask? Well, you probably didn't ask, but I'm going to assume you did. Why so many? Well, they each have their strengths and weaknesses, pros and cons, and all that nonsense, so let's go over them, shall we? First, let's get rid of the buckler standard. Place it on foot. Get rid of the Viking round I have strapped on my back. And here you go. And what I have left in my hand is a stand-in for an aspis. If you can see the grips, my elbow is near the center, my hand is near the rim. This is what is called an argo grip. This isn't a proper hoplon, of course, but it's as good of a stand-in as I could get. Now, so the hoplon was used, aspis. Some people claim it was called, but you know, I'll call it a hoplon because I already did. It was in shield wall. You notice there's a lot to the left of my elbow, my hands, my fingers, meets the rib, and from this position, I can thrust very easily. First low, high, poke that guy. No, I don't have to come up high to get over, which I would if it was more like this. I have to come up high, so the underhand grip, as I call it, is needless. So, and there's no advantages to it. You can just go watch that video if you want. So I can poke if I have a sword or something. I can stay covered and stay sharp a bit effectively. So you think it's a good shield in shield wall? Yes, but when it comes to this guy dying and the guy behind you dying, you're on your own. You're in quite a lot of trouble. First off, it's strapped to your arm, so you can't get it out in front of you that far. You have to put it up like that, but still, that's kind of weak. You can't really bash with it, of course, doing this does nothing. You can't hit with the edge, but again, it's no more than punching range. You can't block low effectively. It's hard to show, but set this spear on this shoulder. He's here for a reason. Now, you may or may not be able to see the line. You can't hardly tell when the camera's playback is rather shit. But in order to block this line, which is right next to my ankle, I have to go way out like this. And you notice I'm exposed. He hit me in the back all at once, which is a bad thing. I have to, So, it's a disadvantage, I'd say. I'm blocking to your weapon side. Good luck on that. Give me a turn like this, and then get rolled over because notice if I get being shot, all the force is going to get right into you, so yeah, it's going to be all lovely. Or you can turn your arm up like this, and it'll pivot some. But, so that's about the only way you'd have to hold it like this. You can't block like that. So it can be used as long as they don't decide to try to get you low. Then you have to try to turn down all the way like that. And notice it pivots along my elbow, so rotating it up and down doesn't really move it that much. As opposed to if it was gripped in the true center, instead of my elbow being there, well, that would alter it quite a lot. So, that's the aspis. Hoplon, or whatever you want to call it. If you want to get rid of it, it's not exactly easy. I'll throw it in the corner. Don't need you anymore. So easy, stop that. You try to shake it off and kind of get stuck, and all they have to do is rotate it, and the arm's trapped, especially if they rotate it like this. You can't help but go like this, it's the way your body works, and it's very bad. It's a bad thing to be bound like that. Don't worry. For the aspis, that's pretty much it. Breakthrough group, not so breakthrough. Seagulls. Set you in the corner and move on to our next contestant, the Viking Rats. You know, the one you've seen in a lot of my videos, and since it's a Viking weapon, a Viking shield, you have a hand axe. Now, this thing, for shield wall, works really well. Your shield right here will be overlapping your neighbor's, your elbow will be pressing against you, so you'll be locked in tight. Arrgh. Can't really get through that. And from here, you can still hack pretty effectively and thrust and whatnot. And if you have an axe, you can reach over a pole and make an opening. That's what you have to do. You make an opening like your mate stacks of ha 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 ha! And you laugh. So, but what if they get your mate on both sides and you're by yourself? How is this? Very good. is actually really, really good for single combat. I can stand on the guard, which would be something like this, so you can't hit me there, you try to hit me on the side, boom, I'm covered, hit me low, I'm covered, I don't have to expose myself, I can fight, I can hit you with this, reach out, poof, get all this extra reach. You don't hit the boss is defensive only. Except for like on a Scottish targe. But beyond that, the boss is just protecting you. Burglars, the edge is stronger than the flat, as you know. That's why you hit with edges, not the side. So, you're fighting with this, I can keep my hand covered, then you can come up like that if I want. You try that with the aspis, just that, be about like this, you're bound. It's not a good idea. So, this is much better in group combat, or single combat. It's pretty good in group, so take your pick of those. This is my pick. But I can also have another shield and another weapon. Grab this. The butler standing, small shield. This is about 18 inches. It's a little bit. It does the job. Stop that. That thing is long. Grab the hand. New weapon. Love this thing. Now. You done? Okay. So, grab this out. And as you notice, you hold it out. It covers you very well. It can't get to you high. It can't really get to you low. And you move it fist fastly. Boom, boom. Block around here. I can cut under it effectively, which you can't do with a larger shield. You can't stand like this. Is what God number this is, but this is a buckler guard up here, and then whoosh, cut under, come back. Pretty good. Useless for single or group combat. Keep mixing those words up. It's useless for group combat because it's so small. You can't really make a good shield wall. You can stand next to your mates and have a bash with them, but you're fighting as an individual and but a group of individuals, if that doesn't make sense, but it makes sense in my head, damn it. That's all that matters. So you have this, you can fight effectively, get in close, you know, stab, or bottle bash, whichever you prefer. It's not prone to kinda hard to hook this little bastard effectively. He moves. You know where your blade is, or poof, or, you know, like, fast, great for single combat, not so great for group combat. So, we've gone from the aspis, which is, you might be able to get a 22, good for group combat, not so good for single combat. You have the viking round, which is the one that fell, is good for both, though admittedly not as great as either for each. And then you have this, which is great for single combat, not so good for groups. So, that covers most everything about shields that you need to know. Am I forgetting anything? No, I don't think so. So, tell you.